Ever since the Pardongate story broke, some crime victims have been demanding that the trustee program be terminated. But would that make financial sense? Tonight in a Who's Accountable investigation, we're asking, are we sacrificing our safety to save the state big bucks?
It's quite impressive. The Department of Corrections Trustees program saved taxpayers in Mississippi tens of millions of dollars in 2011.
So it saves money for the government, but it also is a rehabilitating type opportunity for inmates, especially if they're learning a skill that can be used once they've finished their term.
These controversial Governor's Mansion trustees, four murderers and an armed robber, turned the program upside down. Governor Haley Barbour said he pardoned the men to give them a second chance and save taxpayers money. Now, many fear they will kill again. But according to 2011 figures from the DOC, felons that took part in prison programs had about a 5% less chance of being repeat offenders. And that saved the state more than $7 million. The state calculated that inmate labor saved the state over $33 million.
This is a cold-blooded, premeditated murder.
19 years ago, Randy Walker watched David Gatlin murder his friend and then shoot him in the face. He's terrified about Gatlin's free pass.
If at this point I see David in my space, I'm going to assume he's hunting me, and I'm going to be afraid for my life.
Pastor Matt Friedman works with inmates. He believes violent felons can change.
But I do think that there perhaps is an opportunity for the governor to make some things right that have gone wrong and might save the state a good bit of money.
Now that the trustees have been booted out of the governor's mansion, somebody else will have to pick up the jobs that they did. And that means taxpayers will be held accountable for paying for that new labor.
Some of the things they were doing were key functions that will have to be replaced by people who will be paid either as state employees.
Governor Bryant hasn't yet said how he plans to staff the mansion in the future.
And a spokesperson for Governor Bryant told me the mansion will be closed for the next 2 months undergoing repairs. He says Bryant will use that time to reevaluate staffing needs for the facility.